Girl, are you ready?
I'm so ready.
So pretty much the entire time that we've been dating, she has wanted to see a sea turtle. It's always been one of her favorite animals. We've been to all these places. We've been snorkeling, we've been diving, we've done all this stuff, and she has not seen a sea turtle yet. I ended up seeing a few of them in Australia. It was a magical moment being like 25 feet down and following them all the way back up to the surface. You guys will see some of that in the Australia vlogs, which are coming soon. But unfortunately, she didn't dive that day, so she didn't get to see them. So she's been super jealous and super salty about that for so long. And today we are finally making her dreams come true. We're gonna be going to the Cayman Turtle Farm, and we're gonna be swimming and touching and feeding and doing all kinds of stuff with sea turtles. So it's gonna be a good day. Let's get going.
Try so hard to get away. Think about you every day. Try so hard to live without. No, no, mas.
We made it, girl. How excited are you?
I'm so excited.
Oh my gosh, I'm pumped. The only thing I'm kind of sad about is most of this is outdoors, and yet again, we have kind of a bummy day. Over here, the sun is starting to try to come out over the sea, but over in here, it's just like a little overcast, sprinkling, that sort of thing, but we're not gonna let that get us down. We're gonna have a good time.
If anything, it means less people.
That's right.
They're so big.
All right, guys, so since it was so windy in this first section, a lot of the audio didn't really turn out that great, so I figured I could hop on, give you guys a quick little voiceover, let you guys know what's going on. So this is the Cayman Turtle Farm. They're focused on research and conservation and breeding of these sea turtles, not to mention they're also one of the biggest and most well-known tourist attractions here on the island of Grand Cayman. And these guys you see swimming around right here, these are green sea turtles. They're an endangered species. They're the largest of the hard shell sea turtles. They can actually get up to 5 feet in length and up to 700 pounds, which is absolutely ridiculous. The video does not do it justice. These guys were massive, and it was really cool to see up that close. Now, they can also live to be up to 80 years old. This one right here, her name's Sparky. She's the oldest currently in captivity. She is 80 years old, which is just crazy to me. She's been through a lot. She's seen a lot in her life. And it's wild, man. Now, this pond right here that you guys are seeing, this is actually the breeding pond. So this is where it all goes down. This is where the action happens. The sea turtles float around, swim around, do their little sea turtle thing. And then on the backside, there's actually a real sand beach that they can climb up on. They can dig their hole and they can lay their eggs. And now every time a sea turtle lays eggs, they lay like 150 to 200 at a time. And in the wild, a very small percentage of those actually end up making it, like in the 1% to 2% range. But the cool thing is with this center, they're able to control it better, and it's over 99% make it. So once they lay their eggs, they actually take those eggs and put them in an incubator. And depending on the temperature that they have that incubator at, they can control whether they get males or females. So they can kind of keep their levels correct. They can keep what they need for breeding in terms of both males and females. And then, of course, they also release a lot of the rest back to the wild. So they're helping build up the population of sea turtles out there. And then a very small percentage actually goes to turtle meat. So turtle stew, that sort of thing, is a huge part of the Cayman culture. And so what this center does is they provide that to the local market so people can get that because it's a part of their culture, but they don't have to go out and poach these things out in the wild, which I think is definitely a good thing. So it's pretty cool what they're doing here. It was really cool. There were a lot of, you know, different various facts and stuff. Our guide was really, really nice. I'm not going to bore you guys with all the details. If you guys ever get a chance to go yourself, you definitely should. But let's cut to the part where we get a hold of them.
Oh, it's like a fingernail.
Yeah.
Really?
But when you get over, I'm trying to get used to it because you're gonna actually hold a baby now.
He's posing for you.
So we're making our way around, and I think we're gonna go to the like swimming touching pool here soon. We're gonna be able to hold some babies. Whew, this is pretty cool.
I get you this one.
He's so
tiny.
He's so cute. Hey, I'm rubbing you. Stop flopping.
So you rub under the neck like that?
Yeah, that's
so
what I'm trying to do.
So this one is squirt, and this one is hug.
Sunshine is shining far away. Bird's eyes is looking out. And they can see that you're mine. Because when we're together, your love is controlling my brain. Like plunging inside of that fire I cannot contain. Our love is like a heat wave. It's burning through the evening rain.
We're supposed to be moving on to the next part of the tour.
They've also got like birds and other reptiles and stuff like that here. So we're supposed to be moving on to that.
But she just won't get out of the turtle pool. Oh my goodness. So this is like a little snorkeling area you can swim in, and they actually do have some turtles in there you can swim with.
I don't know if we're gonna do that today because it's kind of cloudy and the visibility's not that great.
And over here, they've got like a couple of nurse sharks and some barracudas. You guys can see a shark right here. Two nurse sharks just right there together. So those guys are honestly kind of friendly. You don't really have to worry about them, but I think there's glass separating underneath us, so otherwise these kids might be freaking out. But this is cool. I just wish we were here on a better day. The viewing glass of the predator tank. Those guys are mean. Coming by for a little show. We're about to feed those pink birds we were just talking about. You have two options. You can stoop down and give it to them on the ground, or you can hold your hand out and have them land on your arm and eat it. And that's what she's going to do.
I have a bad history with birds and they're...
She's been pooped on it quite a few times, but you'll be okay.
Look at that, look at that. Look at that.
That's so cool.
What's up, guys?
Hey.
They're pretty cute. What do you think?
I like these guys better than the big ones.
Oh, come on. They're all beautiful in their own way.
She is.
What do I have to do?
Sorry, Chelsea.
What's your blood type? I'm just kidding. I don't need to. Show me a flat palm. I'm going to put her here. She's probably going to stand over. And then you could slowly turn your wrist over.
Okay.
You got all these steps?
So she's going to step over here, and then I'll
She's
going
to step
this.
Here, and you just turn your hand that way. All right? Breathe. Now turn your hand.
She's so pretty.
Hi. She's like looking me in the eyes.
That's okay.
She's so pretty. Good job, Chels.
Why is she staring at me?
Oh.
Is that yummy?
You came for turtles. You left with a parrot.
I got birds.
What do you think?
She's always been pretty nervous around birds, so I think this was a good growing experience for her.
I had a bird incident and then I got nervous.
Yeah, we'll talk about that later at some point, but we're taking baby steps back to being brave.
Turtle farm complete. That was good stuff.
I'm not ready to go.
Like we said, if only it was a slightly better day, but it is starting to get better right now. We're coming down to the water here because
the waves are crashing up over this barrier like crazy, so we kind of wanted to come check this out. Oh man, this is crazy. Oh!
Woo! Why do
That's
I feel like
nuts.
I'm about to get stoned?
You probably will. So Chelsea, we made it to hell. Lance
Always
just took us to hell.
Here.
This is like one of the major tourist attractions here on the island.
It's all this. What'd you call it? Shore? Iron Shore? Iron Shore. I think it's a form of lava rock, but you guys can see. Just kind of a weird natural phenomenon happening here.
Very weird.
That's pretty cool. So these are all those tourists that we see on the cruise ships and stuff that have those shirts that say, I've been to hell and back and stuff like that.
This is where they went.
This is Ivan. He runs hell here. You guys can see he's the devil. He's actually just back here. I think he's gonna come out in a second. Is that a new hair accessory or what? Some seaweed. Nice.
Oh. Yeah.
Oh, hey, beautiful. What's up?
Hey, baby.
It's the next day. This is actually our last full day here on the island.
Oh,
I'm so sad.
Oh my goodness. I cannot believe this trip has come to an end so quickly. I was worried this was gonna happen because we've only been here for 5 days, and I feel like there's so much more to do than what you can do in 5 days, especially when half of that time has been with the tournament and stuff. And I'm not complaining, I'm just saying I feel like we need way more time, but unfortunately we don't have it. So we're gonna try to make the most of it today. Chelsea, where are we going?
Somewhere called Rum Point.
I am so excited. So, unfortunately, this trip, I don't think we're going to be able to go to Stingray City. That's like one of the major things that you do here in Grand Cayman. So, we're definitely going to have to come back and do that. But Rum Point is also a major, major thing, especially today because it's a Sunday, it's a weekend, and people are going to be out. So, basically, this is an area on the eastern side of the island, I believe, which we haven't seen yet. So, we're going to be exploring a new part of the island. And it's a sandbar that's like 200 yards offshore, and everybody brings their boat. There's like 50 to 100 boats all lined up, tied together, playing music. Everybody's having a good time. And the sandbar is like up to here on your chest. So everybody just hangs out, listens to music, drinks rum, obviously, as per the Rum Point, and just has a good time. So this is going to be a fun day, a nice relaxing day. We've been working hard at the gaming convention, late nights, that sort of thing. So this is going to be awesome. Let's do it, girl. So before we head to Rum Point this morning, we made a quick little stop here in downtown Georgetown. This is like the major tourist trap where all the ships come in and it's all busy with tourists and stuff. As you can see, Chels has the Gamers Bay trophy. We came down to the beach to grab a couple of good pictures for him on our nice camera. And now we're gonna head back and make our way to Rum Point. All right, girl, we made it. Shout out to Lance for the drive.
So,
everybody was talking about how it was gonna be such a long drive. It was on the other side of the island. It took like 30 minutes. We drive that much to go to dinner every night when we go out to eat. But this is Rum Point. There's a bunch of boats out there playing music, hanging out. This looks insane. We got here a little bit late. You trying to kiddie? Oh gosh. We got here a little bit late. It's like almost 5 right now, but we still got some time. We got some sun, so we're gonna have a good time. I'm gonna throw the drone up, get you guys a couple of shots of all the boats because it looks insane, and then we're gonna head out there. The clock is ticking, so stay. So how are you feeling so far? How is Rum Point treating you?
Delicious.
So don't judge me, but apparently they are known, especially by the locals, for their mudslides, so I decided to start with that.
Plus it's like ice cream. You deserve it.
Yeah, it's a nice little treat at the end of a hot day. I've been sweating all day. So this is like, I guess, a little swimming beach area. And then over there is where all the boats are. I think we're going to be walking out there. Lance's cousin actually has a boat that goes to like Stingray City and then Rum Point and stuff like that. So I think next time we come down, we'll probably go out in this boat and go to Stingray City, but he ended up just leaving. So I think we're on our own. I swapped it out for a rum and coke, but I guess this is what you do. You just walk out to the boats the entire way. It's just a little sandbar. Only gets up to like maximum of chest high. So we're gonna head out here and see what's going on. Lance's cousin left, but he might know a couple of other people with boats out here, so we'll see what happens. Chels, you all right? She hates it when she touches like seagrass and stuff or anything like squishy on the bottom, and there's quite a bit of seagrass, so she's moving a little slow. Chels, I don't know if I told you, but when I was droning, I saw a couple of huge, huge rays that could be coming for you.
Stress,
I would say we're doing a good job of that right now. Chelsea's getting on random jet skis. Bye! Alright, so I would say it's been about like 15 minutes or so. We met some friends, they gave us free drinks, which is really cool. Everybody here is so nice, and seriously, it's insane. I actually think I might have just found her. She's the jet ski going around the boat right here. It's just about to go around the front. I think she might be driving now. I don't know, I was gonna say, I haven't seen her in like 15, 20 minutes, but hopefully she's okay. I'm supposed to have her drink that they made for her, but we'll see. She's back. I wasn't worried at all. So we met a friend named Andrew.
boat.
Good morning, it's the next morning. I have not had a chance to look at the GoPro footage from last night. I'm not even sure how much of it turned out because it was really dark out there.
We got a little litty. We had some fun. They were the locals.
I mean, Andrew, he probably won't see this video, but he was one that like invited us on his boat and was, you know, giving us drinks and stuff like that. He had a heavy hand. He was pouring those pretty heavy. I would say it was like 80% rum in those styrofoam cups. So that was a good time. Came back, we went and we got some food. We came back and we passed out. We 100% just like, we were done. So good morning, it's like 7 a.m. We're about to head down to the beach. This is our last day here. We leave at 1. So I don't know if there's really gonna be anything to vlog. I'm probably not gonna bring the camera down there because we're just gonna kind of hang out and enjoy the sunshine. We might, Lance and Daniel want to take us to like a local restaurant place before we leave. So we might go there and we might try something weird like oxtail or like a truly local dish.
So I'm down. Are you gonna try it? Will you try a bite at least?
Questionable. It depends on what it, like, how it's prepared.
Look at her wearing sunglasses in the morning. That's when you know last night was a little much. All right, guys.
So we're gonna pack up, get everything organized, head down to the beach, hang out. If we end up trying out some of the local food, we'll let you guys know. If not, we'll probably see you in the airport.
I think things could get worse. They have these little, like, I won't call it like a trampoline, but it's really just a floaty. And come out here and the hotel just sets them up every morning so you can come chill and you can be in the sun, but it keeps you cool. There's all these little fish. I don't know if you guys are gonna be able to see them. I think they're gone. If they come back, I'll have to show you guys, but they're like a decent size and they're all swimming all around us. It was kind of cool. So yeah, this is gonna be our day for the next like 4 hours. I think I can deal with it.
Here we go, girl. Look at these big boys. Holy cow, this is cool. We probably want to go in the front here. We're towards the front, but that's a wrap.
On an absolutely amazing trip. Cayman is one of the favorite islands that we've ever been to, and we are definitely going to be back very, very soon. So thanks to Daniel and Lance and everybody who made this trip so great. We'll see you guys again soon.